live television events usually come with a live studio audience. Am I right, girls? This morning we've shipped in the girls from Loretto College in Cooperoo. But have you ever wondered how...
Loretto girls represent!
Yeah, they're my people.
This is the schoolies Joe never had. But have you ever wondered how studio audiences stay so hyped and how they actually remember to clap on cue? Well, enter the warm-up guy. They're actually the star behind the scenes, getting everyone ready for the fun. And Michael Pope is probably the best in Australia. Guest reporter Cass Thorburn hung out with him on the set of Dancing with the Stars.
Hi. This year I was fortunate enough to be a cast member on Dancing with the Stars. Just standing here now, getting ready to walk on that dance floor again, fills me with a little bit of fear, but so much excitement. I'm not here for dancing today, though. Let me show you. Come and have a look. Michael, a stone-cold audience at a television show would be a nightmare.
It would, but in a way, every audience starts out stone-cold. And so that's my role, to warm them up, even though I hate that title, audience warm-up, but that's what it is.
You don't like the title?
No.
Warm-up guy sounds so cool.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, that's nice to hear it from the other side. For me, it means getting them focused on what they're here to see. I'm the middleman between the show that they know and love and have watched on telly for weeks or months or years and the strange space that is a TV studio. And I'm that conduit who gets them focused and answers their questions and get them all looking at Cass so that when she dances, everyone goes, marvellous. When you hear that beat really kick in, then find that 2-4 beat and clap along. Ten percent of what I say tonight, I may have repeated, but most of it is ad-libbing. And again, it's about focus. If they're looking at the judges, then I better be looking at the judges and grab that focus back. Let's have a look at the week that was for this couple.
So what other shows have you done over the years?
I started in 1990 on Blind Date.
Welcome to Blind Date. And now, here's the star of the show, Greg Evans.
My role there was, yes, get them in a good mood, but also it was the good cop, bad cop. I had to tell the audience to not signal which of the three people their friends should pick on the show. Mike Munro, This Is Your Life, I did that for many years. Australia Day concerts on the steps of Parliament House in Canberra in front of 30,000 people. It goes on and on.
And we were talking a moment ago and I said, well, you couldn't have done the Logies because I didn't see you. And you were like, see, that's such a rude crowd there.
That's why I don't do it anymore. No, I did it for 18 years and it's a great fun night and a chance for me to catch up with friends and colleagues that I know.
What about someone who wanted to get into this? What advice would you give them?
Yeah, it's a closed shop. There's no real opportunities. Get as much flying hours as you can doing any kind of MC sort of work. Go to shopping centres and flog things outside a $2 shop. Put your hand together for your mum's 50th birthday party. Just take any chance to be that first one who says, excuse me, everybody, can I have your attention, please?
And Dancing with the Stars, has this been one that you've really loved doing?
Oh, absolutely. I had the joy of doing it many years before, and it's fantastic because of seeing people out of their comfort zone but then thriving in it, in their new zone. It's fantastic. And the music, any live music is awesome, and the band here with Dorian is absolutely brilliant. 300 people all rooting for the one person going, I want you to do the best that you can, is a fantastic event to be a part of, yeah.
I think I should give it a go. What do you think?
I don't know, I saw you in rehearsals. No, you absolutely should.
Let's give it a go.
Don't tell someone you're going to do something, just do it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, pretend I didn't tell you to do it. Can I phone a friend or is that not this show?
No, different show.
Different show.
We're all friends here, aren't we?
Yes.
Yes. Do it again.
Okay, men in the room, yo. Yo! Women in the room, ho, no, yo!
You can't say women, no ho!
Yo!
You make it look so hard.
Can I say that? That segment was amazing, and Michael Pope has taught me some great tips. I think I now know what I have to do to win the audience over. Okay, so you ready? Okay, first, I just want you to do a bit of applause. There you go.
Stop.
OK, now I want you to do a great big cheer. Yeah! All right. Now, put it all together on my cue. And that was What in the Weird.
Brilliant. We can stop using the canned laughter now, Joe. Well done.
Hey.
Hey.
Actually, it reminds me of a story about Roman times.
Hey!
How good's Michael Pope? He is just a legend of the industry. To wrangle audiences the way he does, he's such a superstar.
And at the Logies, he performs miracles.
he really is the heart and soul of these big live productions, because if your studio audience is flat, you feel the energy different on air.
Or at the Logies, drunk.
Yes, that's very true.